of the ban, according to the court, and what it says today, will be able to go into effect, partially lifting the stay on the president's executive order. A huge final day in the highest court of the land, and still a lot to figure out at this very hour. What does it all mean politically? What does it all mean for the State Department? What does it mean for the country? Let's go to Washington right now. CNN Justice reporter Laura Jarrett is standing by, and outside the Supreme Court, where all the action is today, CNN Justice correspondent Jessica Schneider. Jessica, let's start with you. If you've had a moment to catch your breath, break this down for us. What did the justices tell us today with regard to the president's travel ban?
Well, Kate, somewhat of a surprising decision and opinion from the Supreme Court here, a decision that is 6-3, three of the justices dissenting, Justice Thomas and Gorsuch and Alito. But what this court has said is that, yes, this travel ban in part can go into effect. They will be hearing arguments on the entire executive order next term. But it's a partial win for the people who brought this case, and it's a partial win for the Trump administration. The Supreme Court today saying that foreign nationals may still be banned into this country. However, if a foreign national has what the Supreme Court called a bona fide relationship with a person or entity here in the United States, they must be allowed into the country. The Supreme Court here specifically referring to some of the challengers in this case, including one man out in Hawaii who wanted to bring his mother-in-law here. In fact, right. His mother-in-law, interestingly, actually did get a visa over the weekend, so that a bit of a moot point. The Supreme Court also referring to people who come here to work, to also go to school. Those people, in fact, will be allowed into the country. But what's interesting as well about this, Kate, is that the three dissenters, Justice Thomas did in fact write the dissent. The newest justice, Neil Gorsuch, joined this dissent saying that no, the travel ban should be allowed to go into effect in whole, not just in this partial remedy that the Supreme Court has issued today. I'll read you briefly from Justice Thomas, his dissent, saying essentially that this ruling by the Supreme Court will cause confusion. Justice Thomas saying today's compromise will burden executive officials with the task of deciding on peril of contempt of court whether individuals have a sufficient connection. So I really do think that that's the key point here. The Supreme Court sort of split this ruling, but the question remains, how exactly do you establish a bona fide relationship with a person or an entity here in the United States? And does it in fact, as Justice Thomas alludes to, will this cause perhaps more confusion at the borders and more of a headache perhaps for immigration officials? Kate?
A lot in there, and they still haven't even heard the case quite yet, and still so many questions. Great to see you, Jessica. Thank you so much. We'll be back with you. Laura, I want to bring you in on this because an important part of this is the road to the high court and how we got here. And that is something that you have been covering very extensively. How did we get from the White House to where we are today?
Well, that's right, Kay. And we forget that the president signed the first executive order just 7 days after he took office. And there was that immediate period of chaos where no one really knew, did it apply to green card holders? Did it apply to people who had some sort of temporary status, right? There was all sorts of confusion. And so then they went back to the drawing board. The Trump administration tried to clarify and narrow the scope. But then two court of appeals said, nope, that's still not enough. We're still putting the travel ban on hold. And they kept it on hold for all intents and purposes since earlier this year in May. And it's interesting, you know, the courts had said there were constitutional problems with it, and they were looking back to Trump's campaign statements and saying that showed some sort of impermissible discriminatory intent towards Muslims. But the Supreme Court doesn't address any of that. Their point is really looking at what is your close familial relationship with someone here in the U.S. And if you have one, all right, well, you can come in. But if you don't have one, the ban is in place and you can't come in. Now, the key question is what's going to happen with the implementation. Obviously, the Department of Homeland Security and the Justice Department will be reviewing this closely. But the president did sign an amended executive order earlier this month saying in 72 hours, once the Supreme Court's decision comes down, if it lifts any part of those previous decisions, then it's supposed to be going into effect. It's supposed to happen in 72 hours. So we've reached out to Homeland Security and the Justice Department to see what the game plan is, to see how they plan to avoid some of the chaos from last time, Kate.
All right, Laura, great to see you. Thank you so much. A lot to get through in this. Laura's setting us up perfectly. Let me bring in right now CNN.